We welcome back today Diana Graber. She's a digital literacy educator and advocate. She was honored with the National Association for Media Literacy Education's 2017 Media Literacy Teacher Award. She is the co-founder of CyberWise, which is a leading online safety and digital literacy organization, and the founder and creator of CyberCivics, the popular and innovative middle school digital citizenship and literacy program currently being taught in more than 40 U.S. states, the U.K., Canada, New Zealand, and Africa. And it is a real pleasure. The book is called Raising Humans in a Digital World, Helping Kids Build a Healthy Relationship with Technology. You know, we keep saying this now more than ever, but Diana, welcome back.
Thank you so much for having me.
And congratulations on all of the wonderful, wonderful reviews you're getting on the book and the work that you're doing.
Oh, thank you.
I love what you're saying is that you're trying to teach kids to use technology to strengthen relationships with real people. And I think that is so important.
You know, it really is, and I feel like every day it becomes even more and more important because everywhere you look, you know, you see really young kids staring down into screens, and the time they spend looking at a screen is the time they're not spending looking at a human face and being able to read emotions or understand feelings and all those really important human capacities.
So how do we get those handheld devices? How do we get them out? I mean, I was just watching. I was in LA, and a friend was just sharing. He was in a coffee shop, and he said, "This kid." I said it the other day. This kid came into the coffee shop. A young man, the phone in one hand, a newspaper in the other hand. He put the paper down and ordered his coffee drink, and then went right back to the newspaper and the phone call. And I, you know, that kind of sums it up.
You know, it does. And I think a lot of what's going on today is that kids are really getting their cues from their adult role models. And, you know, we're the first generation to be dazzled by these really awesome devices, and it's very hard for us to put them down, you know, for a lot of reasons. And for good or bad, that's what young children see, and so they're really modeling our behaviors. So unless we want to change the cycle, you know, or keep the same cycle, we're going to have to change our behaviors. And I think it starts with adults being able to put down the devices now and then to do other things, and then hopefully the children will follow.
Absolutely, absolutely. So let's talk about your new book, because you really want to empower kids to set their own limits with technology. And, you know, the question is, we hear about these stories of how young kids learn how to call 911, and we see these little kids who have saved grandpa's life and have done amazing things because they were able to dial the phone. But how young is too young?
Well, I mean, those things are really easily taught. I mean, we can still use a landline to do those important things. You know, where I think it's too young is when a real young child is staring at a screen in lieu of doing other things. So, you know, I'd like to stay away from age range and look more at what they're doing online. I think it's sort of a spectrum. As kids get older, you introduce them to other things they can use their devices for when they go to school. They can start using it for homework help. They can use it to keep in contact with their parents. And, you know, it's a spectrum and it's balance. You know, we have to teach kids when is the right time to grab for the device and when is the wrong time. And they're only going to learn that if we help them establish that balance.